With all due respect, I think the argument is wrong in the way that it's been put, because tax cap is not the way to address fraud.
Charities work with the most marginalised communities. You know, I don't know if any of you have ever tried to persuade an employer to get a blind person on their payroll. It's blooming difficult work.
Even though we are quite a large organisation with a lot of staff, we are only taking on very, very, very tiny contracts. And if we are, then I dread to think how scary it is for smaller organisations.
I don't know if any of you have ever tried offender management. It's blooming difficult work. And what we need in the contracting environment is a recognition of risk sharing, and not simply offloading risk onto what happens to be a very willing voluntary sector.
I just quickly wanted to say, if you gave Big back its £425 million that Labour stole from it, we'd solve a lot of small charities' financial problems at the moment. But that's not my question. Andrew, I'll behave.
I think the major problem, and it cuts across most of the things that we've seen this afternoon, is that charities are an afterthought and not a first thought in policy making. And if they became a first thought in policy making, we wouldn't have some of the dire unintended consequences that we see and unfortunately experience the negative consequences of on a daily basis.